Welcome back. We're joined now by an extraordinary actor who is creating a piece of Irish theatre history for her new role in new Irish drama, Rathmines Road.
Rebecca Root is best known for her role in the BBC drama Boy Meets Girl and will soon be appearing on the big screen in Hollywood blockbuster The Sisters Brothers. However, Rebecca is making history here in Ireland as the first transgender actor to play a transgender leading role on the Irish stage. Rebecca, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
You're
Rebecca.
Very welcome.
How are you?
Thank you.
You are making history, is that correct? As the first transgender actor to be playing a transgender role in Irish theatre.
Yeah, apparently, so they tell me. So,
fantastic.
Yeah. Someone had to be the first.
Tell us about the play, Rebecca, Rathmines Road.
So it's a co-production with Fish Amble, the new theatre, new playwriting company, and the Abbey Theatre. So it was a big draw for me to work at the National Theatre of Ireland as a half Irish woman myself. And to work with Fish Amble was a very important thing for me in my career. The play itself examines our response collectively and individually to an allegation of sexual historical assault. So it's a very timely piece.
Very
even
timely.
Though
very
topical,
it was first written 3 years ago, and it's been in development for 3 years.
So pre the Me Too movement.
Absolutely, yeah. But how prescient of Deirdre Kinahan, the author, and Fish Amble to put this play together. And then all of a sudden, it's all coming true on our screens. You just think, when you watch the news... Yeah. You could be watching segments of Rathmines Road.
Of
it's astonishing.
Course. Yeah.
And when you read the play first, did you immediately think, this is for me? Or were you challenged by the material?
Challenged, but I loved it from the moment I read it. And I was immediately gripped by the material, the quality of the writing. And I thought, oh, I'd love to do this. I didn't realise that it was a sort of a, they sent me the script and I thought it would be, would they like me to audition? And it turned out it was a bit of a gift for an actor. You know, they then said, well, are you available? Would you like to do it?
A straight offer, that's... nothing quite like it. Yeah.
You're an actor as well.
Fantastic, fantastic.
Yeah, it doesn't happen so often.
They are the rarest of beasts, though, the straight offer. Yeah, no, we'd like you to play it. Really?
Yeah.
It's a done deal.
Yeah.
Happy days.
Yeah, and I happened to be, and I was still available, so... because that first came through in February or March this year. And amazingly, I was still available. I turned down another job to be here to do this.
But you're very proud about your Irish roots.
Yeah,
and,
very much.
It's obviously great for you to come over here and work, as you say, in the National Theatre.
Yeah.
But you have Irish roots.
Yeah, my mum's from Clontarf in Dublin. Yeah.
My neck of the woods.
Oh, right,
yeah,
really?
See, I knew there was good stock
only
there.
Down the road.
Yeah. The North Sider. Come on, the North Side.
So tell us about the BBC drama, just in case anyone's watching this morning and isn't familiar with that particular drama, Boy Meets Girl.
Yeah, so Boy Meets Girl was...
Kind of a defining role for you,
very
isn't
much. I mean, I've been an actor since 1990, and I used to say to my students, I was teaching at the time, said I was an overnight sensation, 25 years in the making, because I was plugging away, and you know what it's like in the business, you're plugging away, chipping away, knocking on the door, and then in 2015, Boy Meets Girl came along, which was a BBC Two sitcom comedy drama. I played Judy, which was the lead role, was the girl of Boy Meets Girl. And we ran 2 seasons on the BBC, and it was really well received. And again, it was kind of a groundbreaking role, really. It was hats off to the Beeb for commissioning it and putting it on, because it really did change the landscape.
But we need broadcasters and commissioners and producers to make those changes, don't we? To push the boundaries, to do something different.
Yes.
In order to bring about change, especially for the likes of yourself.
Yes, exactly. And the thing is that it's incumbent on the national broadcaster, if you like, to reflect society, contemporary society.
But they don't always do. They don't necessarily
always do it, precisely. Yeah. So it was very important and wonderful that they did, because it really gave a wonderful profile to my community as a trans person. Mm. And all of a sudden, people wrote to me saying, you know, I see myself on the TV screen every Saturday night or whatever. And to be part of that was an extraordinary privilege.
That's incredible. Mm. Your transgender journey, Rebecca, you kind of felt you were different very early on.
Yeah.
Maybe 4 or 5?
Yes, that's right. Yeah, I mean, you always have a sense of what you are, whether it's, whether you're right-handed or left-handed or whether you're... I don't want to oversimplify gender identity, but I felt a deep incongruity with what I was, what I'd been given at birth. So, but it takes years to accept that and then to understand that and process that and then
and to question it yourself.
Yeah.
To come to peace with
and
yourself.
And reconcile it in your own head, I suppose.
Precisely. And a lot of people sadly don't. And
yeah.
I was at the point in my life where I felt it was like a sink or swim, really.
Mm.
And I felt that I had to do something about it. And so I embarked on transition. And it was a long, quite a long time ago now. It was 2003 that I began my transition.
And in 2003, not so many people talking about it
in the way
we are now. So a bigger struggle.
Yeah, quite. I mean, I happened to be... my acting career wasn't doing much at the time. And I happened to be working at the Royal Opera House in the box office as a day job, like you do.
Mm.
And they were incredibly supportive. And I was really lucky that I happened to be working in a liberal artistic environment where I was accepted.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I must say they were great at supporting me through my transition.
And the work just keeps on flowing. And you had a couple of huge projects you did last year, one in particular, a Hollywood movie which starred Jake Gyllenhaal. Tell us about that.
Yeah, it was extraordinary. Jake Gyllenhaal, Riz Ahmed, Joaquin Phoenix, John C. Reilly, directed by one of the world's great auteurs, Jacques Audiard, a French director.
An incredible lineup.
What a lineup. Yeah.
What a nice lineup to be a part of, eh?
Yeah.
Tell us about the movie itself. What is the movie?
So, The Sisters Brothers is a Western. It's set in 1850s, California, Gold Rush, America. It's about two hitmen. They are brothers whose surname is Sisters, hence the title.
Very good.
They are sent on a mission to track down somebody. Who is a chemist and a scientist, played by Riz Ahmed. Also on his trail is a detective, played by Jake Gyllenhaal. And I come into the story about halfway through as I run a town with a fist of iron. And the Sisters Brothers sort of grill me and I try to play them off. And I have a couple of really nice scenes with
them.
Did
you ever think, when you were teaching, that one day I'll be in a Hollywood Western?
Never.
Like a Hollywood Western?
I know. It's crazy, isn't it?
Do you know,
I thought after Boy Meets Girl that my career might pick up a bit.
Yeah,
you know.
Well, they might become more consistent, the work.
Yes, but a Western. And I also thought that I wouldn't play really period pieces because I'm 6'1".
You don't
see many women of 6'1" in period costumes. It's just been, I've done The Danish Girl was a period piece, Colette also out this year, that's a period piece, Sisters Brothers, they're all kind of, so maybe I'm being a costume drama actor now, I don't know.
Yeah, but it's opening doors, and for people who are watching this morning, and we've had plenty of transgender people on the couch talking about their journey, and the structure is still not there in Ireland for them. There's long waiting lists for various things that are absolutely crucial to them living a normal life.
Yeah.
So I think it's really important for them to see you and to see you enjoying success.
Yeah.
You know, not only being comfortable with being Rebecca, but enjoying success in the area that you love.
Yes, exactly. I mean, I couldn't feel more gifted, you know. It's really... I always say that being trans was really a bit of a curse until I accepted it.
Mm-hmm.
And now I've turned it around and I'm using it to my advantage, you know.
Well, listen, very quickly, tell us once more when the play is on.
So, Rathmines Road, we're previews at the Civic Theatre in Tala at the moment, last preview tonight, and then next Tuesday at the Peacock Stage at the Abbey Theatre until the 27th of October.
Okay. All the usual outlets for tickets. This has been a pleasure to meet you.
And you. Thank you so much for having
me. Continued success.
Thank you, Rebecca. Well done.